Fue el volumen del día. That's right. Okay, so en el euro dólar va un buy stop al 1.1768 hasta 1.1775/80. So euro dollar goes a buy stop from 1768 up to 1775/80. That's right. You can place the buy stop maybe at the 1780. El buy stop puede quedar al 1780. Compra pendiente 1768. Con take profit a 1780. Okay. Sí, recordar hacerlo con el doble de posición, doble de lotaje, si que tengo venta abajo. Double lot here on the buy stop if I have sell transactions down below. Bien. Vamos por la libra. Pound dólar. Okay, acá está un poquito más, más simple porque hay solamente un único intervalo inferior que podemos dejar posición pendiente. Y ese es del 30.83 al 30.75. No lo podemos dejar antes. So, with the pound dollar, we can have, like I said, sell stop from 1.3083 with a take profit at 1.3075. Venta pendiente 38.3, take profit 37.5 con libra. Así es. Euro yen, solamente el take profit porque ya tenemos compras. Euro yen, just the take profit because we already have buy transactions. The take profit goes for 1.3360.61. That is the take profit. Y después de ese precio, después de ese take profit, after that take profit, until 1.3360.61, it goes another take pro another buy stop, a different buy stop at the 1.3370. Okay? 1.3370 up to 1.3380. That's right, little by little, guys. De a poquito, porque son zona de highs. Little by little, because it's highs areas. So again, buy stop 1.3370 with take profit 1.3380. Así. 1.3370, take profit 1.3880. Con ahora ya. Okay. Let's go to dollar yen now. Dollar yen, we set it a sell stop. We already set the sell stop at 113.42 with a take profit at the 113.33. That will be the safest seller's range. That's it, guys. Sell stop 133.42 with a take profit at 133.33. Venta pendiente. Independiente, 1.3342. Take profit, 1.3333. Oro, nada. Nothing with gold. And dollar CAD, neither. I wouldn't recommend anything with dollar CAD, neither. No, dollar CAD, nada. Porque mercado sube para venderse y cae para comprarse. Los intervalos no nos sirven, son muy chicos. So dollar CAD is not useful, anything in the area. You know? The ranges around it, they are too tight to consider pending transactions. It wouldn't be convenient, you know, no sería conveniente con el dólar CAD, así que oro, dólar CAD, nada. Preferencia en los dos es venta. Yes, the projections, and we would like to have it is to sell a dollar CAD and gold, but we can't do anything in the area as far as it comes of pending orders. You know. Tipo orden pendiente no sería conveniente. Ok, voy a cortar la grabación.